I'd like to have a look at a method for dialing in a square block that may need some work done on it on a lathe, such as making a round end on it or a hole drilled through it in a certain location. So what we have here is we have a square block that has been milled in a milling machine. It's now sitting on a surface plate, and we're going to have a look at doing layout on it. That's why the layout blue is on the end of it. Once the layout blue is dry, the machinist would then use a height gauge to do layout in the location they desire. This is a kit of Toolmakers Buttons, and basically all it is just a sleeve with a screw that runs through it. The inside diameter of the sleeve is considerably larger than the screw. I have set a center drill beside it so you can get an idea of the scale of this tool. Looking at this picture of the bottom side of the Toolmaker's Button, you can see that the screw protrudes through the bottom of the sleeve, so it will be able to go into the material we want to dial up. And also, too, you can see that the bore on the sleeve is considerably larger than the screw, allowing the sleeve to be manipulated around the axes of the screw. This will be very important when we go to do our setup. The machinist is now ready to center drill and tap the block to accept the screw for the Toolmaker's Button. In this picture here, the machinist is center drilling the block. It's a good idea, especially with small center drills, to use cutting oil on them, run them at a fairly high RPM, and peck drill the block in order to not allow the flutes to get clogged up, causing the center drill to break. Now the machinist is ready to tap the block that has been drilled, and the Toolmaker's Button will be added to that. You need to make sure there's enough thread that you can screw the part of the screw that extends down beyond the Toolmaker's Button into the block, so you want to tap it a little bit deeper. You also want to use great care with the tap handle that you don't bust the tap, as it's very small. The machinist can now put the Toolmaker's Button into the block. The screw should not be tight, just enough to hold it in place, but still be able to move that sleeve around the screw. A gauge block buildup is put underneath the Toolmaker's Button to mimic the center of this part. So let's assume, just for argument's sake, the height of this block is 1 inch and the Toolmaker's Button needed to be put on the center. So the center would be half of 1 inch, or half inch, up from the surface plate. We now need to subtract half the diameter of the Toolmaker's Button. So for argument's sake, let's say it's 100 thou in diameter. So we would take a half inch, subtract half of 100 thou, which would be 50 thou. So the gauge block buildup would need to be 450 thou to the bottom of that block. In this picture, we have the gauge blocks from the surface plate up to the bottom of the Toolmaker's Button. And we also have an angle plate sitting against the far side of this square block. Please notice the gauge blocks built up from the angle plate to the side of the Toolmaker's Button. Now, if you were to take your finger and push down against both of these gauge block buildups and snug that screw, it should be fairly close to being in the right position. Now we want to do a gauge block buildup to the top of the Toolmaker's Button. So in other words, half of that square, assuming the hole is going to be on center, plus half of the Toolmaker's Button. So the example I gave was 1 inch, so it would be half of 1 inch, plus half of, if the Toolmaker's Button was 100 thou, we would add 50 thou, so this buildup would be 550 thou. We then want to run a test dial indicator, or some type of a dial indicator, over the top of the gauge block buildup and set zero on the bezel of the dial indicator. We then want to move the dial indicator over the top of the Toolmaker's Button. Hopefully the reading will come to the same zero on the dial indicator that we had just set with the gauge blocks. If not, we need to tap the bottom of the Toolmaker's Button or the top, either moving the Toolmaker's Button up or down until it gets in the right position. It's a good idea to tap the Toolmaker's Button with something that's soft, such as a piece of wood or a piece of plastic. Once we get zero in this position, the block is then laid over on the side perpendicular to the position it's sitting on the surface plate, and it's checked again to make sure that the top of the Toolmaker's Button is correct in that position. After both of them are checked and zero is accurate, make sure that screw's tight, check it one last time, and then you're ready to use it. The part can now be put into the lathe, and the toolmaker's button can be dialed in with a dial indicator. In this case, we have a four-jaw chuck chucking onto the square stock and a dial indicator on the toolmaker's button until it reads zero. Please note the second dial indicator on the face of the square block, making sure it is perpendicular to the toolmaker's button. Now the machining can be done on the part. In this case, the end needs to be made round, keeping the backside square. Because you'll start out with an interrupted cut as you bring the end down to being round, it's probably a good idea to leave the toolmaker's button on until you get it round, or at least get rid of that interrupted cut. In case the part happens to shift in the chuck, then you still can dial that toolmaker's button in. The toolmaker's button can now be removed and you can finish the part. In this case, it's being bored out, because now we have an outside diameter that we can dial to, and again we could put a second dial indicator on that face because we now have a true round surface that we can dial to. And that's it.